The second geometry method of the shell tool is the revolved method. It has two construction methods, simple and detailed. Let's first use the simple construction method on the floor plan. With this method, the profile polygon is a quadrant. With our first click, we define the position of the center point. Our second click defines both the radius of the profile polygon quadrant and the starting point of the revolution angle. The third click defines the end point of the revolution angle. In 3D, we can see the result. The revolution axis is a vertical line at the center point we defined. The profile polygon is in a vertical plane and is revolved around the revolution axis. We can use the same method in 3D to create a simple revolved shell. Center point, starting angle and size, then ending point of the revolution angle. In the case of the detailed method on the floor plan, we first define the profile polygon. We can again use space clicking on existing elements to define the profile polygon. Then we need to define the revolution axis with two clicks. The last step is to specify a revolution angle, 360 degrees in our example. This is how the result looks in 3D. Both the revolution axis and the profile polygon lie in a horizontal plane parallel to the XY plane. The detailed method can also be used in 3D. We can use Polyline Creation commands from the PET palette to create the profile polygon. Then define the revolution axis with two clicks. And with a last click, define the end point of the revolution angle. Alternately, we can use the tracker to specify a revolution angle value.